Wound. There we go. Is there anybody in there? Can't hear if there's any music. Oh, we gotta go to the scene. Now then. Hello, is there music? Is there music? Yep, there's music. Hello. And welcome to Exanima Arena Mode. Why? Because I like to. I was watching a dude that calls himself Ego Viking. I have not streamed in 10 days. And, Ego Viking. I watched him because I was planning on streaming, and then I didn't. I watched him instead. But this is what I've been wasting all my time doing instead of streaming. I wasn't streaming because I didn't think anybody would watch it, and probably no one will. But here it is. You know what I need to do? Oh, crap. Is there any way to set the game? Gaming? Yes, Exanima. Exanima. It doesn't exist. It is not a game that YouTube has any idea exists. But oh well, there it is. Now then, we're back. Check the sound one more time. Yep, there it is. So, Exanima. This is the arena mode. That is the store. That is something that I want a better version of. This is my money. 12 of these coppers is 1 silver. 12 of these silvers is 1 gold. Surely they have a name. I don't know what it is. I've already got one of these. If you go here and hire people, you will eventually find within the group of people that you can hire. You see novices and inept fighters and the occasional expert, and once in a while even a master. Huh. Well, they don't have one. But as it just so happens, I do. See this person right here? Telost the Merchant? You hire them on that screen, and then they show up here. You can only have one. If there had been a merchant over here, and I had tried to hire them, it would have told me you already have a merchant in your employ. The merchant, you can tell them, generally speaking, what it is you want to buy. Rank of the equipment, and then whether you want both armor and weapons, or only armor, or only weapons. Those are your choices. It's kind of annoying. I'd really rather, at this stage, to be able to just buy whatever I need. But that's what you get when you let other people build your video games for you. They do what they want. So, all this is crude plate. This thing right here, the close helm, apparently is the best helm. And then the exceptional quality is always apparently the best quality. I could use some better sabatons, I could use some better leggings, I could use all kinds of things, but we don't have them. I hate the close helm design, but it's the best one. It's the best helmet. If you get the exceptional close helm, it is the best helmet, period. My best character, I have 2 master level characters. They're both equally good, really, but Dane is second best, and the reason Dane is second best is because I've had him specializing in two-handed weapons. Two-handed weapons are the way to go right up until about novice level. Once you hit adept, you start getting really nice shields, and two-handed weapons have a real hard time with shields. It can be done, and I will show you. But for just ease of making money, there is nothing quite like the old sword and board. So you'll notice that even at expert level, he's not wearing a metal breastplate. That's because they make these shields, these points right here. You're only allowed so many points in each ranking. So 30 of 30, I'm already full of points, and yet I don't have any metal chest plate on. So I had to go all the way up to master level to get my metal chest plate and still have a shield. Can actually use that black shield. You can actually use it, as you can see, all the way down at adept level, which is two levels below here. Right here. But I use this one because it requires fewer points. I'm already stripping off most of my armor. It doesn't end up mattering because the shield is so much better than armor. You can begin to just rush people headlong, flailing wildly, and win 9 times out of 10, which is something you cannot do two-handed ever. Like, if we go and look at Dane master level, this is one of the better weapons, probably the best weapon, either this or the halberd. You're not gonna swing headlong at people with this. They're gonna come up inside of the reach of it and beat the crap out of you, so you have to be very tactical with this build. Whereas with the shield build, you don't have to think anymore. It just takes a while to get a guy into shield build. So, Sorsha is basically the founder of the feast. She is the owner of the little fighting club or whatever. She only ever boxes. Why? Because you cannot die boxing. You would have to try so hard to die boxing. So she's gotten all the way up to the rank of novice just by boxing. What used to happen is I started out, and you can see Rignan Roach the Third. That means there were two other ones that died. Stonehenge Jr. means there was a Stonehenge that died, and Dane Jr. That means the first Dane died as well. And as a matter of fact, the very, very first Rignan Roach, Rignan Roach Primus, I started him out as the owner, and he died, thus ending the entire game. So that's how I learned not to use your primary character in duels, because they die. Turns out you can, and like, if I ever get Sorsha all armored up the way Rignan is, I can fight with her, but there's no point because I have three other first-person players that these three, Rignan, Dane, and Stonehenge, I play. Finkus, Brunn, and Cole are computer-controlled. Telost, of course, is the merchant. I feel as if I've described about all of this game that anyone could possibly want to describe. So, on to the carnage. This is the carnage. This elimination at the upper levels is where most of the gold is made. I don't know why Finkus is over here. This is master versus master. This is the only time I ever lose using the simplistic head forward, and it only happens occasionally, but I'll probably lose this time because... Now you see the little red thing? The little red circle is the cursor. This is a mouse and keyboard game. You can play it on a Steam controller, but by the time I learned enough about the controllers to actually set up the Steam controller the way it really needs to be set up, I was already used to playing it on the mouse and keyboard. See how he backs away? That's at master level, they finally begin using all of their skills in a way that they can defeat me sometimes, but that one wasn't fast enough. Look, I was barely injured, The yellow or green bar, or yellowish green bar, is basically like an energy measure. And when you get hit, it saps you of energy, and you slowly go down to zero, you pass out. There's also red that comes and starts showing up in the strain. If the red thing ever devours your entire life bar, that's the end of that character. So, and if it ever devours your main character, that's the end of that arena playthrough. So we do not fight with our main character anymore. I don't. I know other people probably do. A lot of aspects to this game that I don't get into. I don't particularly care for the dungeon mode that they have, because it's the same exact viewpoint. You see, it's a quote isometric view. This is not isometric. This is clearly a top-down, three-dimensional view. We'll see. We'll see. See how, if you look at it sideways like this, there's foreshortening? That means it's not isometric. In point of fact, I don't think that if you can look at it from all these different angles that it's at all possible for it to be isometric. But whatever. What I'm using the term isometric in the way the devs use the term isometric is mostly top-down. This is as close to your guy as you can get. This is as close to my favorite viewpoint as I can get, and I have to constantly hammer the space bar to keep in this viewpoint. And for this game, I'd want to be out a little, because people out at the periphery, you want to be able to see what they're up to. What happens normally is your guy turns, but your viewpoint stays the same. If you keep hammering the space bar, it'll turn the whole map for you. There's no setting that I'm aware of that makes that happen automatically, therefore the controls for this game become very arcane. More on that later. Here's another halberd wielder. It's either a halberd or a poleaxe. The halberd and poleaxe are the ultimate weapons. Although I tend to use hammers because at this level, crush damage gets through armor better. And at all levels, the big giant hammers just do a metric ton of damage. So there's no point in this game where a hammer is bad for you. This guy is better than the other one, as you can see. Either that or I'm just not focusing as well. In the sword and board playstyle, the only point is to stay as close as possible to these two-hand wielding bastards. Hopefully when they hit you, they only hit you with the shank of the weapon, minimizing the amount of damage you take. Also, have this guy skilled up to where he can swing and use his shield at the same time. Something that you can't necessarily always do in this game. So until you built a character that has the skill set, this doesn't actually work. But once you build the character, it's kind of auto-win until you go to take on the ogre. And I have yet to beat the ogre. I suspect the way to beat the ogre is for everybody to have tons of armor and pole arms. You're allowed to take two of your bots into the ogre fight with you. I've been building up decent bots, but I don't have them with enough armor. They die horribly within a few seconds of fighting ogre. I also should probably be trying to distract the ogre somewhere, but the ogre battle is pretty weird. We'll show you the ogre battle, and at some point in the hours and hours of this game I'm going to stream today. Because I'm just going to sit here playing this goofy game like I've been doing all fucking week. Trying to buy armor, because that's all I do. The reason I was talking about the dungeon game, and the reason I don't like it because of the viewpoint that it has, is part of the dungeon game is looking for stuff, And so you're looking for tiny little things on a big giant screen, top down. And so therefore, I just don't like it. I don't like it. So I don't play it. But what I'm going to probably do is cheat, look online and see where all the things that you're looking for are, because there are apparently some really badass battles. But I don't know to what extent if there's any point in anybody watching the stream, because basically I'm just streaming me doing the same thing over and over and over. Part of it, I might be able to make a nice highlight reel of death scenes. So that might be worth it. See how there's one thing that they haven't done yet that's kind of too bad. It's a great blood spatters. You can see. Blood on the body. There's no blood on the ground. Where's my ground blood? Where is the growing pool of blood under this guy's corpse? That's the one thing that I'm missing in this game. Oh wow, close up. It's a little harder. Wow, that was fast. It's a little harder to do this. This close in. No, it's not. I just realized I should have been doing it this close in all the time. It's actually easier. Because you, oh, he missed. When you fall down, people often try to do the straight down, and by people I mean bots, often try to do the straight down coup de grace swing. Which I try to do too whenever I knock anyone down. Because chivalry is dead. It's dead like Fred, man. I mean, chivalry is just crushed. Right quick, see the little red button, how it's one arrow and two arrows? That's how you run or walk. I do that by holding down the right mouse button. When you release the right mouse button, then you have this little target, and then you hold the left mouse button to swing. If you do the swing right, that's a feint. And you can feint. There, that's three feints. It's not as easy as you might think it ought to be, but nah, too long. Oh, that was three or four feints in a row. I don't do much feigning. If they ever get a PvP version of this game, the feint will begin to be very important. I discovered the feint with the bots using it. I was like, it looked to me, here we go, coup de grace, nope, I didn't even swing downward. We'll just pretend like I felt chivalrous that time around. And not that I was incompetent. But in this straight down, I mean in this headlong flailing fighting style, again dependent on you building a certain set of skills plus having a good shield and some good armor, you always keep the little circle directly opposite of the guy you're fighting, and then you just hold down the W key to lunge forward repeatedly, thus staying as close to them as possible. And then when they move away, you might hit them, and if they stay in close, you might smack them around with the pommel of the sword, and sooner or later they all die because the AI has no idea how to deal with that tactic. The way to deal with that tactic is to back away and back sideways. Here, I'll show you. So, I have it. See how she's kind of stutter-stepping? That's a lunge, or what they call, I think they call it a sprint or something, but it's not a sprint. It's a lunge. And then if you just tap the key, they kind of jerkily, you know, back. And the way to deal with the AI when it tries to do that to you as you back away, back away. Where's a bigger room? You can back kind of catty corner. See how she's backing kind of in a circle? And then you lunge forward. And what you can do is you can lunge forward and see how she turns? Lunge forward and turn. She follows the cursor even as she's lunging. So you tell, multiply that effect times whatever weapon you're swinging, and you can wrap the weapon swing around and hit them around their shields and crap. And that is how you handle the head-on attack from the AI. But the AI doesn't know how to do roundhouse swings yet. And so that is why this little tactic works almost all the time. they'll probably fix that eventually. This game's still in, like, this game is for sale, but it's in alpha. And then their actual game is called Sui Generis. I don't know how to pronounce anything in Latin, but anyway, Sui Generis. Sui Generis. Whatever. Damn it. That's gonna be their role-playing game eventually. Once they get a lot of other things hacked out. I'm not 100% sure how much I like this game for an RPG. I wish it was developing, first of all, in case I hadn't mentioned it yet, I wish it was the over-the-shoulder view. I don't want first-person view, I want your classic fantasy over-the-shoulder combat view. I want it, and I want it now. But oh well, they've already said on the forum they're not doing that, so I'm screwed. Look at him, see, he's got his leg all lame or something. Happens sometimes. He eventually breaks out of it. Another thing that happens from time to time, his sword and or shield arm. Well, I've never actually seen both. Either the sword or shield arm can get stuck behind your back for a while through the vagaries of the supposed physics-based combat. I don't know if they built their own physics engine from the ground up. I signed up for the forums, but it's been like 3 days and they haven't allowed me to post anything yet. So I don't know if they're ever going to let me post anything, and to whatever extent I'm going to sit here and gripe about the game, they may never let me post. I mean, I like the game, but I'm going to gripe about it because there are parts of it that I just find kind of goofy, one of which is the abject refusal to put it into a over-the-shoulder view game mode, because this, especially for a role-playing game, this just doesn't cut it. Also, they have plans to put missile weapons in the game? Okay, well now you have missile weapons in a game whose maximum range is like, what, 20 yards here? I mean, seriously, what's the point of missile weapons in a game with this short, you know, you can't shoot anything. It's stupid. So, they need to get over themselves and go ahead and transpose this into the first person, or not, I don't want first person strict view, I don't, but it needs to be that over the shoulder view that's kind of the classic combat view in the modern video game. You know, Witcher 3, Mortar, all of them have the same. I don't think of it, Mortar's kind of like this, isn't it? Witcher 3. yeah, Batman Arkham is like this too, isn't it? So this is not unprecedented. Nevertheless, I prefer Witcher 3, Dark Souls. That viewpoint is the one. Assassin's Creed, which to my mind is still the best action RPG series, the Assassin's Creed. And the only thing I don't like about it is I wish they would keep it the freaking fantasy and history mode. But you mean, you can't do what they've done with the game and do what I want to do, so they had to make a choice and they chose to do the thing that they chose to do. And it works. I mean, there's tons and tons of examples throughout the years of the supposed time travel, one way or the other, you know, time travel. That's what they're doing. This is very interesting to me that the focus of the game is on hand-to-hand combat or ancient to medieval level. Oh my goodness. Oh, good grief. I missed 3 times! And that is the other thing that kind of pees me off about this game, is this viewpoint. You don't swing exactly where that little cursor is aiming. You actually have no way of knowing exactly where you're swinging. Just hours and hours of practice will give you some vague idea where you're going to swing, but it's not. They talk about skill-based, and there is some skill to it, but it gets to the level that it could be automated entirely. I mean, this process, if they were careful enough with their coding, they could make bots fight the way I'm fighting right now. Easily. Simply by coding a line through. You would define the center of the character, and you would define the center of the opponent, and then you would automatically generate an aim point at the exact opposite point, about how far away I tend to hold it. You could automate that, and this would make them fight exactly the way I'm fighting right now. And it would be quite challenging. And then if you were to switch it back and forth to say, okay, for a while he uses this headlong charge, and then, wait, now he's going to use the sidestep. Now he's going to use the sidestep feint. I can never feint. There he goes. He almost fainted. You could code that into the game. Look at him twitching. sadly, that's not really a twitch. That's one of the things that I've seen in many of the games that have ragdoll physics. They get hover in a little spot where they can't quite resolve where they're going to lay, and then they twitch accidentally. But it still looks like a twitch, so you could call it a feature instead of a bug, and nobody would really know the difference. This is what I'm doing with my life now. I'm spending hours and hours. This is the weapon I use. And if he ever connects with it, you'll see why I use this weapon. When I'm doing two-handed, again, I actually connected the coup de grace move, but at this level, nothing is a coup de grace. The amount of armor here. Oops. Oh, I thought I was gonna get hit. But nope. Caught it on the shield. Yeah. There it is. See that? Even in plate armor. That kind of damage. That is why you use hammers. And crushing damage. I'll show you this in a second. Crushing damage is the absolute best damage type versus heavy armor. Look how much damage she eventually did. But the ones with the halberds are actually the most dangerous at this level, because the halberd does similar damage and is much faster. I don't think it's really a halberd, because a halberd is like an actual, you know, 10-15 foot long pole arm. Everything that they call a pole arm in here is really just a two-handed axe of some sort, except for the spear, which is of course a spear. I get tickled watching them wrestle. I mean, there's absolutely no known point to doing that, but it just looks funny. It's like he's trying to pummel him with the hilt of the sword. And it does seem as if it sometimes results in some damage being done. Oh my gosh. At this level, I believe this was a master versus master. It might not have been. It might have been expert. No, it's master, because I'm wearing my master helmet. That's my best helmet. Let's see, the helmet. My expert helmet has an open face. So this is the master helmet. So this is the master level. Oh, I should have remembered. Of course it's master level because the very first opponent was the purple knight, and the purple knight is master. This is the halberd. See, it's much faster. See how fast it swings? I wish the two-handed sword swung as hard as this thing does, because I much prefer the visual of the two-handed sword. But the halberd is the king of late-game weapons two-handed, and yet they still can't hit me. But look, see, look, I was half health. And every once in a while, one of the halberd ones kicks my ass. Every once in a while. Problem. Ooh. Get up. We both fell. We both fell. No telling why we both fell, but we fell. Fell down. Fell down hard. We did not get up again for some time. See the screen jerk around the way it does sometimes? That's me hammering the space bar so that the damn action isn't behind the fucking wall. Cause that's annoying. Just flinging across the floor, why don't you? Whenever they fall unconscious, they drop their weapon and it's sometimes quite hilarious. One person, one of the most dangerous weapons in this game is the meat cleaver. And the reason the meat cleaver is dangerous is because you typically run into it in the early game when you've got Jack Diddley Squat for armor. And the meat cleaver does cutting damage, which is what gives you that bar. The red bar. In other words, it's killing damage. Cutting, killing, killing, cutting. I think Impale probably does killing damage too. I don't really have any knowledge of how the thing actually works. But anyway, I've been killed by the meat cleaver so many times in the early game. That's where the vast majority of the previous Rignans and Danes went, was the meat cleaver. Because you don't have any armor to protect you from the cutting. And so instead of seeing this little green bar get shorter and the little empty thing, you see red, 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 red. Each swing is mostly red damage, and you die eventually. That's just how that works. Thinkus. Run is my best robot. See, whenever I don't have... Oh, there's an elimination. Whenever I don't have an elimination match, I default to some sort of group combat. I'm going to go ahead and do this one just for the sake of the stream. Even though there's a grand total of one person watching it. Okay, would you come over here and help or something? Holy cow. Would somebody fight this other guy? I'm fighting both of them. I'm almost dead already. Well, unconscious. Rune's like my best guy, and he's freaking totally failed me. I'm almost dead myself now. This sucks. I should have taken a slightly more tactical... I thought I would just pick somebody, and he would pick the other one, and I forgot that he doesn't necessarily always do that for me. Okay, all is forgiven. Oh, I'm attacking my own guy. Well, I'm glad you got that guy. Good job, Brun! I take all the crap I said about you back. I forgot I had a helmet on, Brun. For years and years, poor Brun was fighting close to naked. Run is now an able warrior. Looks like we're gonna do another doubles with Run. Okay, this time we won't act stupid. Okay, Run, you pick who you're gonna fight, and I'll fight the other one. Good man, Run. Good man. You just hold out there. I'll be over there to kill you accidentally in a moment. I haven't killed any of my characters, but I've knocked a couple of them unconscious several times. Friendly swing fire damage is real, folks. I swear I saw him. Gosh, why is this one so much better? Oh, because low level. See, this armor is not good, so consequently I'm taking a lot of damage. And this method of fighting does not work as well at this level. But if Brun can hold out... Brun, you kick ass, brother. Didn't even have to help him. He took care of business on his own. Hell, he took care of business a while ago while I was attacking him. That was pretty stupid. 19. Still got another couple. Exceptional. That's the one I want. Exceptional is pretty much the best quality. 20. 20. 21. Why is the crude one more expensive? That makes no sense. Check this out. Crude plate armor. Less coverage. Less impact defense. Less slash defense. Less crush defense. And this right here is what I'm telling you about hammers. Crush defense is the lowest defense possible. Nothing much defends all that great against crush. But I think most of it is just impact. The hammers do a bunch of impact, which I think is the main thing that drives down the green section of the bar down here. Eventually knocks people out. Well, I would love to see an even more involved combat. Like, instead of just a green bar like that. And you see this blue bar, this will eventually have something to do with magic, but they don't have it implemented yet in the available game. I would like to see a bar that was, and they have this in Dark Souls. Your stamina bar, you know, goes down with each swing. I like that. And then there should be even a third bar which controls the speed with which your stamina rebuilds. So that as you're slowly worn down, over time, your stamina doesn't build up as fast and you can't fight as effectively. That would be my perfect three-tiered tracking for combat, for hand-to-hand combat, and feel free to steal it. Everything I ever say is attribution-only license. Have at it! Hell, at this point, you don't even have to attribute it to me. Here's the damn exceptional close helm. Check this out. Is there an exceptional plate helm? Probably not. Oh, I never got around to pointing out. Exceptional plate armor. Crude plate armor. The crude plate armor is 21 gold points and is gold pieces and is worse. In every way, it's more encumbering, less coverage, and less defense, and costs an extra almost entire gold piece. Do not understand. Is that a feature and not a bug? I don't know. Never buy crude. Exceptional is always the best kind. Sometimes you can't get the exceptional at a certain level, so like, Around novice, for whatever reason, you can get some of the armors at superior or so, but you can't get the exceptional until adept or something along those lines. But at master level, you can get exceptional plate mail, which costs less than crude plate mail, plate armor, which is really hilarious. I love that. That's funny. I find it humorous. But let's try, yeah, superior plate helmet. I need an exceptional plate helmet. Do we have one? You see that superior is more or less the norm at master level. But you see how all of these other ones are plate helms, and this one is a close helm, and we do not have a single exceptional plate helmet. And the one thing that I will tell you if I ever find one is the exceptional close helm is better than the exceptional plate helm, and I don't like it because it's ugly as sin. I'm gonna go ahead and buy one. No, I'm gonna wait until I can get the full armor, and then I'll buy the close. I hate the close helm, but it's the best one, so I'm gonna have to get one. And you know, I always gotta get the best of the best of the best. It's, oh my god, this is not good. How did this? So this is interesting. There's a cleaver in his right hand and the axe in his left. I should probably not use this method. At this level of armor, so this is a master's tier fight in terms of the skill level. But it's apparently what? Novice level armor. And this armor is not keep you from dying. This armor can be cut through. And if I get very hurt, I will just quit out of the combat, because I don't want to lose this character. I will concede before I let him die. You see, he's already got more red damage than he's ever suffered in any of his master's level combats. As you just never take red damage once you get that really good armor on. You get smacked in the face with the halberd, and you just take stun damage. See, that guy may well be dead. Because I hit him square on the noggin just as he was already unconscious with a cutting weapon. That, see, I'm with this red. This is bad. I should not have done this. But at least the watching public will get to see lots of blood. I'll watch this when I get done streaming today and put together a tutorial and a highlight reel. And that will be all of the Exanima, unless somebody shows up out of nowhere saying, "Hey, stream Exanima." In which case, I will stream it until I turn purple, because I do enjoy playing it. But I just can't imagine how this is fun to watch. Oh, you know, I don't know why anybody watches video games, which is one of the reasons why I started streaming. It's like, hell, I can do that. Well, apparently I can't, because nobody knows I exist. But, you know, and I forgot to... A lot of things, like, forgetting... Matter of fact, I oughta... After this combat, I guess I'll go ahead and put on Twitch that I'm streaming. Twitch. Twitter. I don't stream on Twitch because I don't like that Twitch decides that small-time streamers can't be seen by people with weak equipment. YouTube downgrades the stream for me. Which doesn't matter anymore because my stream sucks, but I used to have very good stream quality. And then my equipment pooped out on me. It actually didn't poop out. I have a whole series of videos fighting with the frickin' equipment that I had. At the end of the day, I want a streaming PC. So if anybody out there loves me and wants me to be happy, give me a couple of grand for upgrading this PC completely and then putting together a streaming PC. Probably only need about $1,000 really, because I need... I've already got a video card that I could use for the streaming PC. I'm pretty sure the video card I have in this one is good enough. But I need a pretty good motherboard and processor in the streaming PC, and I need a power supply, and I need a box to put them all in. Have to have those things. Also, probably need another screen. I could use this screen to be the one to watch on the side with and buy a nicer gaming stream, but I guess even with a pretty nice one, that's only about $1,000. And then that's why I need $1,300-$1,400, because I'd also like to upgrade this processor to an i7, which is an i5 currently. So somebody out there, float me about $1,500, please. Thank you, appreciate it. Let me go. I'm gonna announce myself on Twitch. My channel. There's my channel. Some people who mentioned me. Okay, there we go. I don't like the way Windows makes Twitter look, and I'm not sure why it looks different on Windows, but I hate it. There we go. I forgot to mention I am streaming Exanima. Link, hashtag Exanima. I am such an uber idiot. I really should sign into Facebook one of these days, but oh well. Back to the game. Oh my goodness. Where is the game? There it is. And once again, let us check and make sure the sound is working. Sound working? Yes, it is working. And here we go. Every time I switch off of the game, it seems like it turns the sound off, and then I'm always paranoid that it won't ever come back. But it always does. There are those who have suggested that I struggle with anger management issues, and I can only say that if people would give me enough money, I would be happy. I swear I would. Good grief. I'd probably kill him. Blood and gore and gore and blood and gore. That is the fun of this game, to be honest with you. It's the main appeal to me, anyway. You ever played Dark Souls 3? They pull off blood on their small-time enemies pretty cool in terms of splattering on the ground, but they don't put the blood on the character as effectively. And this is very... I like this... shading, texturing, I don't know what you call it, but I mean, it's still cartoony, but it's realistic. Its realisticness is far superior to Witcher or, you know, anything that I've seen in a AAA game, and yet I think this is fairly low grade graphics. So kudos, guys. This looks pretty. I like it. One of my main draws to video games. It needs to look pretty in some sense. And y'all have delivered. You have delivered in spades, just in terms of your texturing and your shading. I love it. Die, you heathen pig. Yeah, that's right, that's what I said. Die. Pit over there with the bars? That is a dangerous little pit, man. I have gotten my butt kicked so many times in the Masters level, high level combats. Because I trip, and then the halberd wielding Masters level combat guys, you'll trip over this thing and fall down, and then they'll just smack you right in the head with their halberd, and that's the end of that combat. That smarts. That's gonna see how that little weapon gets stuck behind their back. They need to fix that. That's not realistic. I don't know if I've ever seen anybody have a hard time getting their arm back around front from behind their back like that. That's just, it shouldn't even go back there. Unless you grab it and twist it around. There are people whose arms physically incapable of moving that direction. Oh, look at him. His little legs get out of whack sometimes, and then he can't turn right anymore for a while. And that's how it goes. Oh, wow. Skirmish mode. Yeah, may as well. Die! Die! Uh-oh. Whoa! Walking around. Okay. Just one more guy. I just tripped over that dude. That was terrible. End around. Run faster. I can't get over here. Finally. A lot of low armor fights causing me to be injured somewhat significantly almost all the time. Run, you didn't quite keep up with me that time, buddy. I think I got plenty of coinage now. Oh yeah, not light. Great rings. I think that one's the exceptional, yes. That's my favorite one too. So there we go. Trade. That stuff on. Man. Only can wear that at the master's level. See, master. Is this master's only? Nope, so I can't replace that. I can't give this to anybody else. Because I need it. Look at that! And look, still 40 points, because it basically replaces a whole host of other crap. If you take it off, look at all the stuff it took off. It's basically a whole load of crap in one piece. is what it turns out to be. It's the shoulders, whatever you call that, whatever you call that, all those different things is what it is. It's what it is. It's all those things. If you hold down the right mouse button, you can turn him around too, which is kind of fun. I would have thought it would have been the middle mouse button, but no, for whatever reason, it's the right mouse button. You can't move him up and down. He only pivots on a turntable. But that's cool. That's cool. That's plenty good. I don't know how much better this is than all of the armor that I had, but it's simpler. Now I need the leggings. There it is. Don't have enough even for the superior one. I have yet to see a exceptional plate helmet. Only exceptional close helms. That's gonna be any of them that look kind of dingy are gonna be rusted or damaged. There's an exceptional plate helmet. Oh, I have seen one. I lied. And it is always slightly less good than the exceptional close helmet. Matter of fact, here's a... Oh, wow, the coverage on the exceptional plate helmet is better. Well, we'll see. I'll find us exceptional close helmet. I guess I'm going to have to buy an exceptional version of each, and then I'll be able to... Oh, look at that, baby. It's so much prettier. Even though it's only superior. Prettier ones ought to also have exceptional quality. Because then you end up having to buy uglier armor, and that's just sad. Well, it's ugly, but it works better, so I guess I'll buy it. Pressing. Master's level doubles. Don't have a master's level double partner yet, but here we have elimination at adept levels, so that'll work. Oh my gosh, back to the bleeding. Back to the bleeding. At this level, the two-handed, even the halberd, is not particularly effective. Because the cutting damage on the sword knocks them out so fast. See, this one's lasting as long as they are because of the shield. The shield is like the ultimate armor in this game. I don't know what happens, but sometimes his legs get all out of joint and then he can't move right anymore. I've noticed that sometimes their weapons kind of come loose from their own hand. Strange effect. Part of the whole physics thing, I guess. But very strange. Part of the whole physics thing. And by the whole physics thing, I obviously do not mean actual physics, because that never happens in reality. But, something about the physics sim in this game causes their weapon to hover a little bit off from their hand when it gets stuck on something. Ooh yeah, now that was a vicious kick them when they're down type of thing. Kick him when they're down, kick him when they're down, kick him when they're down, kick him when they're down. No! Oh, quit dodging. Just lay down and die already. Just give me all the money. Give me all the money. All the money that I want. Give it to me now. So I can buy. I wonder. See, this is what's strange. I could do this all day. They don't necessarily enjoy like Dark Souls level. Somebody told me I would enjoy Dark Souls better if I would just level up until I didn't have to think anymore. And I'm afraid that's true. This game needs PvP as well, and that's the thing. I like the challenge that comes from PvP. I do not like the challenge that comes from... Oh my gosh! The circle thing is driving me nuts. Stop going in circles. This guy has lasted forever. They don't usually last this long. Even at this level of armor, they don't usually last this. He might beat me. That's gonna be sad. Wow, the table. About damn time. Holy shit. Epic battle. It ranged all over. This guy's going down in a fucking heartbeat. He ain't gonna shit. This frickin'... They've taken to going around in circles in a way that gets his legs all cross-waddled, and I really hate it. Do not like. Lightweight, eh? Close down. Superior, close down. Do we even have an exceptional plate helm? I will buy an exceptional. I don't have the money for an exceptional, so I ain't even talking about. Just to be very clear, heavy, which you might think would be more protective. Oh no. Oh no. Heavy just means heavy. It means the encumbrance is higher. For the same price! So no, we don't buy heavy crap. There's no point even having it in here. Ooh, exceptional sabaton. Well, we're gonna have to do that. We buy exceptional goods here at exceptional good buying. Is that exceptional? This plate. And the colored ones are always just like, are your sabatons already exceptional? Yes, they are. So we will give these new exceptional sabatons to Dane. Notice Dane has the widest variety of weapons. What happened was, upon discovering that my, main character could die, I started using a secondary character as the fighter, and that was Rignan. And then I discovered that I didn't want even that guy dying, so I was fighting only the safest of fights with Rignan, which was very slow progress, and I wasn't able to practice, really. I couldn't do the harder combats and learn how to do them, so I made Dane. And the first Dane died in combat, because he was the guy that basically I learned to do elimination bouts with, and elimination bouts is where the money's at. So Dane Jr. here survived, and has come to be the guy that has tested out the most weapons. Whereas Rignan stuck out, well, he's got quite a few too, actually, but he stuck mostly with stuff that was safe. Here you see this thing, and this thing carried him through most of his career. Then this was the first good sword, although the machete works in a pinch at the lowest levels. But really, this sword, at novice level, coupled with the square shield, is where you begin to get the real sword and board play, where your board actually is worth a crap, because the buckler, coupled with the fact that all the rest of the armor at that level sucks, just makes it damn dangerous. So with these weapons, you keep people at bay by swinging wildly, and when they step in close enough, they get smacked in the head. And that's the safe way to fight in the early levels. It works. I swear it does. Well, we just are not getting much master level play here. There's somewhere here. I should. Possibly. I don't know. I mean, there are times when I do better and worse, and I think it's because I'm paying closer attention to exactly where I'm, even though I'm mostly just seemingly just running forward. There's an ideal place to follow him around to get your good roundhouse swings in. Sometimes I'm paying closer attention and getting lots of good swings in. And sometimes I'm just kind of on autopilot because it doesn't really matter, because again, once you get to this level, you're pretty much just gonna win. Until you take on the ogre. And I guess that's the thing, we need... You know, one thing that would happen... One thing that would happen is better AI. Or just... I don't even like calling it AI. Just better... bot management software. That's what they ought to call it. Bot management. Better botting. Better botting through technology. That's what I call it. And they don't know if it's smart or not. Never gonna know that crap. Whoa, we're gonna make computers sentient. You don't know! There's no way to know whether they're sentient or not. There's no way for me to know whether you're sentient or not. Most of you don't strike me as sentient. Which is why you're not watching my stream. God, I've been streaming this an hour already. See, this thing just is the best time killer in the universe. I just sit here doing this all day. If I had a job, you wouldn't even have to pay me that much. You just sit around doing something mindless, kind of like this. That's why I so resent all the good manufacturing jobs being overseas. So I would be so good at sitting around doing the same thing over and over again. Well, anybody can do that. Well, then why the fuck are all those jobs overseas? How is it cheaper to ship crap halfway across the planet? The fuckers are lying to me. They are, they're lying. I'll tell you exactly why it's cheaper to ship things across the planet. It's the monetary system. It's the Forex market, foreign exchange. And the reason for that is, as bad as the United States and Europe may seem to you, everywhere else on the face of the planet sucks even worse, and they don't trust each other. They won't do business straight up with each other. They do business using our banks and our fake-ass money, because our fake-ass money is better than the deals they make with each other directly. And they talk and talk and talk about Pan-Africa and Pan-frickin' Arabia and all these things. They hate each other. They hate each other. That's why they always do business with us. They like us more. We're more trustworthy. We lie a lot, but we lie less, and we kill fewer people per capita. We do what we say we're gonna do. That's what credit means, folks. Trust. It's trust. Anyway, he's dead. He doesn't trust me at all. Die, you fat old pig cow! Pig cow, that is like the combination of the two most edible. Pig chicken cow, chicken pig cow, that's it! Chicken pig cow! Die, chicken pig cow! Watch this. Weapon's too short! Oh, there he goes. You're like, you physically can't get her. I'm trying to get some ham off of this ham hock, but I just can't seem to cut it off. It will not come off. Oh well. So much for chicken pig cap. Die. Die, chicken pig cow too. This is the bloody hell of this game is on display at this level of armor for sure. One of the highlight reels I'm going to have is just Exanima, blood and gore version. God, I'm beating women in this game repeatedly. That's not misogynistic. I don't know what it is. That's an interesting thing about this game. Ow! Well, she made me pay for trying to hit her while she was down. So women are constantly complaining that there aren't enough women in video games. This video game is pretty doggone gender inclusive. But now I feel like I'm just beating up on women, which somehow I don't feel like that's really the way this is supposed to work, but well. I am not doing inept level elimination with my main. This is how they trick you. You can make a whole gold coin almost, minus 6 coppers. Oh, wait. Inept level armor, meaning almost no armor. Novice level skills, meaning the person with the meat cleaver is going to beat the tar out of you and you have no armor. This is a death match. Here, I'll put Stonehenge in there just to show you. This is a death match. Stonehenge is my dwarf. Okay, this is not a death match. This is a couple of guys clubbing each other. Oops. Ow! Oh, crap. That hurt. Oh, crap. Got her back. Did I fall down? I just fell down. There you go. Oh, no, I missed him. I went for the coup de grace. Coup de grace. The coup de grace. Uh-oh. Oh boy, that was a terrible sound. That was a terrible sound. Almost got him. See that sweep? That is the ultimate weapon at this level. See, I got him on the side. Oh, almost got him in the back that time. Oh, yeah! Nothing like a little head clobber in action. Just wait till it. There's the meat cleaver. Godforsaken meat cleavers. Get off me. Get off me. Ugh, if he hits me one. Yeah, no, he didn't hit me too hard. But you see, it's all killing. Go for the headshot. What did I do that for? That was terrible. See how much harder this is than the actual high level combat? Ooh. Ah, cannot get this to pull off anymore. Oh yeah. Stay down, punk. Ugh. Well, no. Ah, did I walk into that one? Uh-oh. Dang, she's gonna kick my ass. The quarterstaff is a surprisingly effective weapon in the early stages of this game. especially in the hands of your bots. All of my bots start out on quarterstaff. Even though the cleaver is dangerous, this quarterstaff... How? Good God. I'm not sure if I'm gonna beat her. And that, man. Damn it! Oh, I'm glad you went for the... Yep. So I didn't die, thankfully. Because everybody was using blunt weapons. I didn't win anything. Did not win anything. Adept will be fine. Adept level. I can still... smack down on some people. Already got his legs all crossed again. It just looks like he's... One of the things that I think happens is there's a skill that makes you attack quickly after a parry. And there's a skill that allows you to attack quickly after a shield block. And there's a skill that allows you to attack even though your shield is still up. Which, see, when he's holding his shield up over his head like that, as he swings, I believe that's that skill at work. Meaning that once you've built up your skill base, this is a far more effective tactic. Whereas if you try this in the early game, you will die and die and die. Oh, for fuck's sake, get his fucking... See, his fucking torso gets turned around, and then he can't move. And I get tired of that. I think it happens when they're turning in circles the same direction over and over again. And that merry-go-round effect is fairly common. There's only two possible maneuvers in terms of dodging. There's short step and lunging step. And that's all there is. So there's, you know, very definite rhythm to this game, and it gets into this turning circles mode that I find incredibly annoying. Look at him, he's gonna kick my ass with the Volge. The Volge is your first really... God damn it, I can't catch him. That's what's going on, I can't catch him. Damn. Yeah, I got caught. Oh no, I fucked up! No! Stop fucking doing that! I don't know what I do. Yeah, the Volge is like the first... pretty good. That's not true. The bill's a pretty good. As a matter of fact, the early game pole hook thing is pretty good, so never mind. But the Volge begins to seem to function a lot like the halberd in terms of effectiveness. Novice? Oh, demons. Just gonna have to do a regular old duel. They're not giving me any decent ones. Not giving me the money. Show me the money! So much armor left to buy. So many people left to arm. I think once I get him fully armed, I'm gonna go back to trying to armor my bots. Never did get them fully. I don't even really have them fully capable of going in after the... Is there a novice level ogre? I think there's a novice level ogre. That thing called the beast. I thought it was going to be like a lion. No, it's an ogre. Or a troll or something. It's a big old thing. Why aren't you dead yet? Fall down. Fall down! You fall down! Okay. Oh, sorry about that. I got leggings. 22. No, I don't have leggings, and that's a lot of leggings. Oh yeah, I'm looking for exceptional gauntlets. Basically anything exceptional. Superior close helm. Where'd that exceptional close helm go? Everything's frickin' superior or less. You scum sucking pigs. And these plate leggings, see how they don't cover as much? It's annoying. And yet they're extremely expensive, so I just don't buy those. Even if they were exceptional, which they're not, I don't want them. So back to the old grind. Oh, here we go. Here we go. This guy is just getting knocked the crap out of. Eventually want to get Stonehenge put together with an axe. I'm pretty sure that the sword works better than the axe. Because it's faster. Larger number of swings is key to this particular playstyle. I almost think the short sword would be better, but maybe not. It might never ever break through this armor. I had to hit people like 6,000 times, apparently. Already had to hit them 3,000 times. That's an interesting mace that will just like a piece of I-beam or something with a handle attached to it. It's like slightly wider at the top than at the bottom. I'm not sure. Like maybe it's, look at his sword caught in the bars of that thing. Ow, that hurt. And yet look at that, he barely did any damage. I think that's that helmet. That's my new helmet. Oh, goodness. Would you just fall down? Dang, you have very good back armor. Hitting you in the back is very much pay dirt. Pay dirt. Is that like an old mining term? It's gotta be. It's dirt. No, no. Farming. Pay dirt. That's pay dirt. That dirt pays. Like, very fertile dirt. Peter. I don't know. love the music for this game, too. I don't think it gets enough credit for its music. I wish I knew what it was. Uh-oh, this is the guy that's gonna give us problems right now. That's the poleaxe. And that's the hit with the poleaxe. He's getting me repeatedly. I don't know how he's doing it. And he got me. Yeah. I should probably... It usually works, though. I mean, y'all been watching me do this. Nobody's been watching me do this, but I've got an hour and a half of stream here. And, usually wins, even at that level. I'll try it again. All the way back down to novice. What's funny is it pays just as well. As long as it's master's tier, it doesn't matter what armor level. Rank basically means what armor you're allowed. That's what it translates to. Almost wanted to do this. Almost, but not quite. Money. I ought to, when the pole arm comes up again, the halberd in particular and the pole axe, I need to go back to the more careful. More careful fighting style, because that's always the one that eventually beats me. I need to try and figure out how to maximize my effectiveness on the poleaxe. No sense losing battles unnecessarily. Boy, this is like... Ooh, that wasn't nice. Ooh, gut slapped right from the get-go. Gotta love it when that happens. Hmm. Ooh. You hit me a couple of times, haven't you? That wasn't very nice of you. Add up eliminations. Beating the tea table crap out of me. Yeah. But luckily, he didn't do much killing damage because... blunt weapon. That's right. Oh yeah, you're just dead meat. Why are you so successfully dodging? Sex. See, I just don't think it'll work. Gotta try it though. I'm gonna try it. As soon as I get enough armor for this guy and every other guy and all the other guys, then I'll go back to working on my dwarf. Die. 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 That's interesting. Crude. Superior. Exceptional plate leggings. There's my exceptional leggings that I needed. Exceptional gauntlets turn out to be fairly rare. What about the sabatons? Mostly just superiors. Any exceptional helmets? I want this one in exceptional. That's my favorite design. Yep, that's the only one. That's just one of the ends. And gets this one because I already got one already. And we have a fucking sick ass helmet here, buddy. You don't even have the main breastplate yet. That's what's funny. Because his weapons have caused him to have to not have much armor at expert level. Whereas at this level, that's about as good as the armor gets at it. I notice he doesn't have his shin things on. Other than that, doubles, bonus elimination. Another elimination. Die! Oh, he is dying. Lots of blood. Next fight. One of the things that I'm not fond of is, and I've touched on this before, See how slow the axe is in comparison to the sword. No real control of high or low swings. I don't ever really quite know why. At one point, I'm swinging at a shield, and at another point, I'm hitting him in the thigh or the kneecap. What I want, axe that swings as fast as that thing. It may just be the hatchet is as good as it gets. There's my baby. Halbert. Hmm. Ow. That's the key, is when you notice that you're out of good striking distance to back off. That's right there is when I would have walked into it back in the day. That's the key. Once you get out of optimal striking range for the sword, that's when they're gonna come in and smack you. So that's when you back off. Good grief, just die already. Oh, that was a bad one. Getting all nervous. Damn it! I didn't hit that hard. That was weird. Problem with the pole hammer in the hands of the AI is it's too slow. I don't really have to worry all that much about the pole hammer. The pole axe and the halberd, you have to worry about. Very much anymore, am I? But I'm not losing to halberds anymore either. Ooh, no. This guy's fast. This one's way faster than the other one. What's up with that? I think what happens is some of them don't have the fainting skill, which is... If you ever see them seem like they're swinging multiple times in a row, that's the feint. And that makes it hard. Durr. Harder. Okay. Well, that's enough. 2 hours of this. I think I'm gonna edit it. I think that's it. Is this working? Is this working? I don't think it's working. Did I stop the stream? Who knows what happened? Supposed. There it is. What's it doing? Where's that? That's weird. Anyway. What was I gonna say? Who knows? Who cares? Point is, I'm done. Have fun. Maybe this will actually.